Hey guys, what's up? My name is Art and welcome back to another video. Today, of course, as you know, it is the new comic book day pickups for the week. Now the thing is that I've gotten a lot of things this week, so I have to break it up into two different videos. Usually I get like one or two things, you know, like my eBay hauls for the week. But then almost everything I ordered just came. There's a couple things that's still out there, but it just came like really quick. I was like, whoa, I can't handle this. I can't handle all this magnitude of stuff. But anyway, so what happened is that normally I went to three shops today to buy some stuff. Nice hot day. Good thing to have my car back. You know, critters chewed up some of the electrical wires. Got that fixed, and you know, now I'm driving my car again. And last night was at my friend's house watching SmackDown and AEW Rampage with the reemergence of CM Punk. Tonight is SummerSlam, and within an hour I gotta leave to go there. Within an hour, watching that, then something else is going on, but I'm going to talk about that later in a different video. With that being said, let me start it off. First thing is Nightwing 83. Out of all the Robins, tell you the truth, I don't think of Dick Grayson as Robin anymore. He's Nightwing. He's been Nightwing since the 80s, and this is a variant cover. Now, the fun thing is, I noticed something recently. Now, look at that price. $4.99. The regular books are $3.99, but the variance is a dollar more. Marvel's is the same price. Cash grab. Okay. Way of X number 5. I've been liking this Way of X storyline with featuring Nightcrawler is, you know, in particular. But, you know, I might be like stopping this one pretty soon. Gamma Flight number 3. Haven't read the first two yet, but this looks pretty cool. Out of 5, so that's cool. I might wait another month or two, then read all 5 of them at once. Not sure about it. But, you know, anyway, issue 7 of Radiant Black. Really, really loving this series. Imagine a bunch of people getting these gravity powers, and everybody had their own methods of why they use these powers. You know, and it's kind of interesting that now they're trying to figure out what the true story of why they got those powers. It's kind of cool. Somehow I missed this last couple months ago. X-Men Legends number 5, featuring the resurgence of the revamp X-Factor. Pretty cool. Moon Knight number 2. I just read Moon Knight number 1 recently. And of course, he's not a poor man's Batman. He's his own character. Trust me, he's really cool. I thought he was a cool character before because of his costume, but after reading about him years ago and even now, he's really nice, really cool. And the reason why this story is really good, it's a shocker. This is the variant cover. I found this and I was like, ooh, gotta like that one. Noctera number 6. Loving the story so far. Loving it. Now, here's the funny thing is, you looking for a book with a strong female character? This is one of them. Okay? This is not no Me Too movement kind of crap, no SJW kind of crap. This is a woman written the right way. Well, you can write women all types of ways, but this is a good version of a strong woman, in my opinion, given her situation. Number 1, the trial of Magneto, when Scarlet Witch dies and is blamed on Magneto, and now is the trial of Magneto. Now, the funny thing about this is that why would he kill his own daughter, especially since mutant crimes are handled by mutants only. So that's the weird thing about it. So, just can't wait to read that. I was trying to see if I could find the variant cover, because months ago, I couldn't see what the variant covers look like. But one of the variant covers looks super nice. But anyway, this one was kind of interesting. And I found this months ago. And I was like, yeah, maybe, maybe not. This is based off the Warhammer universe, which I used to play the Warhammer tabletop miniature game. And this is based, you know, what happened, the main character was like this group called the Space Marines, which is like superhuman guys in power armor, fighting against everybody. There's a female, and everybody said, what about female Space Marines? Well, there's no females in this. But they have their own chapter called the Sisters of Battle. So that's what this is about. So I'm waiting. Now, the thing is, the last Warhammer series, they did, I was very impressed. Because the world of Warhammer is very bloody. And it's supposed to be bloody. It's tame, but it's still kind of bloody, okay? One book that I've been waiting for the most. And this is, now, if you, some of you watched the Loki series, TV show. And some people say, oh, I don't understand it. But the thing is, it was setting up the next big bad guy. They introducing time travel and multiple dimensions. Okay, so with this multiple dimensions, X-Men, Fantastic Four, could actually show up in the Marvel Universe now. Because they could have came from a different dimension. So, and of course, if you didn't realize it, because I they were dropping hints on who the big bad is. I was like, who's this big bad? Who's this big bad? Nothing but Kang the Conqueror, one of my favorite villains. From the 31st century or 33rd century, who conquered and went back in time and fought the Avengers. He's a tough son of a bitch. Very tough. He has ties to the Avengers and the Fantastic Four. So, with this being so, this is going to be really good. Number three is Sinister War. The comic vet talks about Spencer's run. I kind of like Spencer's run. But this is, you know, pretty cool. Star Wars War of the Bounty Hunters, number 16. War of the Bounty Hunters, number 3. I have not read this yet. I read the preview of it. Because I kind of wanted to get everything, then read all of it at once. That way it could be just one big, long sitting. That's one of the reasons why I have so many books, is they're all like mini series, part one, part two, whatever, and I just kind of stacking them, so that way I can read them all together. But then again, I found some other buys. One is Avengers 141. I had this book when I was a kid. I bought this book at a 7-Eleven or a pharmacy, one of those two. Versus Squadron Supreme, got it for a decent price of $8. So that's pretty cool. Avengers 202, love the villain Ultron. $4 book. Now, the thing is, these books are in really good condition. That's one reason why I said, ooh, they're not the best condition, but they're really great condition. This one is a good one. Captain America and Falcon 150, or Captain America 150 with the Falcon, fighting against a stranger. Look at that, 20-cent goodness right there. This is a 20-cent book, so that means this was like in the 60s or so. 60s, early 70s, I believe. Maybe. Don't know for exactly. But, you know, for $3, what a nice book. And this one, I used to read these things all the time. It's called Marvel Double Feature. Captain America and Iron Man, number one. 20-cent goodness. I mean, look at that. They're just ripping from the panels. Love that stuff. And with that being said, that is it for this week's of comics. Now, there's a reason why I didn't buy that many books this week. It's because something else is going on, and that's going to require me to shift some things around. But anyway, the next video would be the eBay hauls. Okay, with that being said, thank you very much. If you like this content, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, give me a thumbs down. Like, comment, subscribe, share it with your friends, families, and enemies as well. And maybe a bus boy or a bus girl. We're equally. But anyway, with that being said, thank you very much. And you know, leave a comment down below. Let me know what you thought about some of these books. If you read some of these books before, or you thought some of these books were kind of cool, let me know. I kind of want to hear what you got to think, what you got to say. All right, with that being said, thank you very much and see you soon.